Hi, my name is Jason Morrell, and in this video, I want to show you how to do waterfall charts. This is an example of a waterfall chart, and the idea is that you show a series of cumulative totals. So here, all the grey bars are showing the cumulative totals for this particular business. And it also shows you any positive or negative impacts in between those totals that happen. Here's how to set up a chart like this. I'm going to delete the chart that's here and rebuild it. So let's look at our data first of all. Now, just in green, just to highlight the fact that these are the totals, starting with a balance of 10,000, as we go through the first 6 months of the year, it shows the cumulative balance in this set of figures. In between each running total, we have revenue that comes in and expenses that go out. So in the first month, we had 8,500 coming in, 1,200 going out. That leaves a balance of 7,300, which we then add on to the 10,000 to get a total of 17,300 for the balance for the start of the next month. And that goes all the way through for these first 6 months. Now, the figures themselves, revenue is obviously positive. Expenses are set up as negative, and that'll show us different colors on the waterfall chart when we build it. To create a waterfall chart, you can be anywhere in this table. Choose the Insert tab at the top, come to this Waterfall or Stock Chart category, and choose the waterfall chart at the top. Let me resize this so we can see things a little bit clearer here. This is the initial waterfall chart that's created, and actually the information that it's currently showing is not that useful. What we need to do is kind of set up these stop points throughout the chart, showing the various cumulative totals, as in the stuff that's highlighted green over in the data. Now, the way to do this is we need to tell Excel one by one that certain bits of this chart are actually the totals. So I'm actually going to start over on the right-hand side here. The last figure there, 48,000. When I click this the first time, every bar on the chart is selected. When I click it a second time, the focus goes solely on that one piece of data. I'm then going to right-click, and there's an option on the context menu called Set as Total. When I do that, it moves this grey column down to the zero mark on the x-axis, and it shows the total there of 48,900. I'm going to repeat that for each of the intermediary totals. So there's one here, right click, set as total. Right click, set as total, and do that all the way through. So when you're done, you have something like this. If you look at the grey bars by themselves, this is the cumulative total. So things were generally going pretty good for 5 months, and then that last month we had bigger expenses than we had revenue, and therefore the cumulative total went down, just a little bit of a dip at the end there. The stuff in between, the blue bars indicate the profit or the revenue that came through. The orange bars are currently showing the expenses or the negative amounts that were incurred in that period. If you took this chart no further, this would be completely functional and perfectly fine to hand over. But let's do some things to this. If you want to change the colors, there are three main colors used on the chart. There's the blue, the orange, and the gray, indicating positive, negative, and cumulative total. On the toolbar at the top, under Chart Tools, the Design tab, we have an option here called Change Colors. And it gives you a number of colorful options and a number of monochromatic options. Now, I suggest you stick with the four colourful ones. And in particular, each of these, we're concentrating on the first three colours in the range. So you see that you've got blue, orange, and grey there, which corresponds to our three primary colours on the chart down the bottom here. If we switch to any one of these other ones, it'll change the colour scheme over here. If you want to customise your own colours, you need to go to the Theme options on the Page Layout tab. So let's quickly change this back to the standard colours. I'm then going to go to the Page Layout tab, and in the Themes group on the left, you've got a few options, one of which is colours. Now, Office is the default color scheme. So everything that's colored within Excel follows this basic color scheme here. You've got a whole bunch of others to choose from. But if you come down to the bottom to where it says Customize Colors, you get 12 different colors you can set. The six accent colors you see here, these are the ones that give you the various combinations that we previously saw in the Change Colors options. Those four colorful options that we saw use different combinations of these six accents you see here. Now, the first one, the default setting, as we saw before, it uses blue, orange, and gray. So it's actually accents 1, 2, and 3 that are used for that first colour scheme. Some of the others use like 2, 4, and 6, and other combinations of the accents that you see here. So let's say that you want to show positive figures or growth figures in a different colour. Let's maybe choose green here. And maybe any negatives in red. And maybe you want to set the totals to some other colour, but let's just leave it as grey for now. Down the bottom, you simply give it a name. And when you return to your chart, you can see the changes in effect. So that's just a really quick video to run you through how to do waterfall charts in Excel 2016. I hope that's been useful. Any questions or comments you have, please leave them below, and I'll see you in the next one.